Tulsa's Gathering Place isn't the only large development happening along our stretch of the Arkansas River.
We got an exclusive tour and update this afternoon on the Cosmopolitan Apartments. News on 6's Megan Farley is live on that story. Megan?
Well, if you drive this stretch of riverside here near Denver, you've probably watched this development progress. Well, today, the folks behind it, they spoke to me a little more about what's going on and their faith in the Tulsa market.
Almost 3 years ago, the lot at Denver and Riverside looked like this, empty and overgrown. But Houston-based developer John Gilbert, who was also behind the enclave in Brookside, had a different vision for it.
We identified this site that I had looked at in 2009. Always liked building near bodies of water possible in the Arkansas River here.
Today it looks like this. The parking garage is taking shape. A large crane lifts items into the construction zone, and framing on the more than 260 one, two, and three bedroom apartments will start next month.
Having the Gathering Place announced around the same time was really unbelievable, so we're very excited to be on this location, also part of the Tulsa community again.
But when I first covered the story, some neighbors like Tracy Spears weren't overly excited.
At first my thought was, you know, we didn't want to have all this construction going on for all this time.
Spears has since changed her mind.
We really haven't had any issues at all. We're just excited for progress.
And Gilbert says his development group has full confidence the Tulsa market can support more high-end apartments.
In other markets, major markets we look at where there is a lot of apartment construction, we don't see that here in Tulsa or Oklahoma City. Local people might, because they're just, I guess, in tunnel vision. I still think there's a lot of room for high-end Class A apartments here.
So the first units here at the Cosmopolitan should be available, they say, they hope, in the spring of 2019, and then the entire project finished at the end of 2019. Live on the scene on the story in Tulsa, Megan Farley, News on 6.